दियो मति सोटी सुडलई पड़ी मुसियन लंगर
பிரசாந்த், உங்க ஆடியோல ஏதோ டிஸ்டர்பன்ஸ் வந்துட்டே இருக்காங்க. ரெண்டு டிவைஸ் ஆன்ல இருக்கா?
மேம் ஒரு டிவைஸ் ஆன்ல இருக்கு மேம்.
ஓகே ஓகே, ஏதோ அங்கிருந்து கொஞ்சம் ஆடியோ டிஸ்டர்பன்ஸ் இருக்கு.
ஓகே மேம்.
சோ டுடே வி ஹேவ் 3 ஐ ஃபர்காட் டு டெல் சம்வன் டு வெல்கம் அண்ட் ஆல் சோ ஐ டு மை செல்ஃப் டுடே. So today we have our 3 alumni with us. One is D. Prashant Bharati, who is a PhD resource scholar, who is about to submit. He has already submitted the synopsis, going to submit the thesis very soon. Then we have Ambika Gayatri. I'm not telling about her anything now. Let her introduce herself to you. Then we have Rajiv also. So he also will be introducing. Initially, let me welcome all the 3 alumni to this platform today, for listening to them, for them to share their valuable experiences and how could they reach this stage. So we listen to them. So on behalf of the CMS family, I extend a warm welcome to all the 3. I extend a warm welcome to all the staff members in the department. In spite of their problems at home, they are all joining on time. So I extend a hearty welcome to all the staff members and the students also. Most of them are joined. So, and it is especially for the final year UG students to know what you can do after leaving the college. I mean, that's the main motto behind this. So some of you are joined. Anyhow, I extend a warm welcome to all the students who have joined. And I think Prashant Bharati can take over the session. We'll talk in detail after the sessions.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, please come.
Okay. A very good evening, one and all.
Please switch on your video also, Prashant.
Video, ma'am.
Yes.
Okay, ma'am. Here, background is not in a proper, not a good background I'm having, ma'am. That's why I turned off the video, ma'am.
No problem.
Okay, ma'am. Very good evening. Today we have gathered for our third day of Alumni Fest. I am D. Prashant Bharati, as you all noticed in the brochure. So I plan to talk in 3 way. One is about myself and about my growth. And the third one is about what are the points that young students should have in mind to pursue their higher studies. So let me first introduce about myself. I am D. Prashant Bharati. I am an alumnus of this institution since 2014. I did my schooling in Tambu Higher Secondary School, completed my UG in Sri Ramakrishna Mission Vidyalaya College of Arts and Science in the year 2012. After completing post-graduation in our institution, CMS College of Science and Commerce in the year 2014, I went again to Ramakrishna Mission Vidyalaya to do my MPhil. And after that, I worked as an assistant professor from 2014 to 2016 at United Institute of Technology. And I resigned my job. After that, I joined as a full-time research scholar in Sri Ramakrishna Mission Vidyalaya. Until this date, I am pursuing my PhD degree in that college. I had submitted my synopsis in February, and I'm waiting to submit my PhD thesis. So this is a very small and short introduction about myself. We all know that well begun is half done. Our mathematics department has begun this wonderful alumni fest 3 days before. It gives me an immense pleasure to participate. In this alumni fest to meet all of you. So I thank the Department of Mathematics, HOD ma'am, and the management for organizing this wonderful event. And I hope this will definitely mold and motivate the young minds like you all. CMS College, especially our department, is the pioneer in organizing alumni meeting in online, which will long last in for many days. Generally, alumni meetings will not last more than a day, and in general, alumni meetings are not online. This is the first time under Department of Mathematics of CMS College has pioneered these initiative steps for conducting conducting alumni fest in online mode. So in this third day, I am very happy to join with you, and this is a very happy moment for me. So I now going to tell about some of the moments between me and the institution. So from my school days, I started to having some passion about poetry writing, drawing competitions. Whatever the competitions will announce, I used to participate in all the events. So in this institution also, I used to participate in all the competitions, like poetry writing in Tamil and English, oratory competitions, drawing, pencil sketching, chess, etc. I participated about the competitions held inside and outside of our college and won many prizes and certificates too. I was continuously motivated by the faculties of our department, especially HOD ma'am, trusted my strength, my talent, and everything. And that's also a reason for my success, other than my hard work, passion, practice, and my family support. I had an experience of being an assistant professor and handling students. Because I handled engineering mathematics for 2 years in United Institute of Technology after completing my MPhil. So motivating students is not an easy task, but our department professors are continuously, efficiently, and effectively doing such a great and tough job. So we have to appreciate them, and we have to make use of them in this short span of time. How they spend time, how they readily come forward to motivate our students. So let me tell you an example which had happened in my life. Once there was a Vedic mathematics workshop in our college organized by our department in the middle of 2017. The session was handled by a farmer by his profession and a Vedic mathematics expert by his interest. And his name was Mr. Nanjundan. He is from Ooty. He used to ask questions then and there between the session. Yes, I already have some interest and little knowledge in Vedic mathematics. I used to answer all the questions and solve all the problems. He became very happy on getting a very spontaneous and correct answers from a student like me. HOD ma'am observed all this scenario, and she was waiting for a right time, and that right time also came. But the right time was that project work time. We were going to do our MSc project. On that time, PG in this institution and outside CMS are all doing PG project in differential equations, topology, operation research in various fields of this Western mathematics. So HR ma'am encouraged me to do my MSc project in Vedic mathematics under the guidance of Professor Vidya ma'am. And that is the first step that motivated me very much for learning Vedic mathematics. I think I am the first person who did the MSc project in Vedic mathematics. Nowadays many colleges starting promoting Vedic mathematics in their institutions after seeing our department activities. Her encouragement still continues. Even being a student, I was invited as a resource person for Vedic mathematics seminars to teach the easiness, the importance of our Vedic mathematics, which is our traditional mathematics. So I had taken 4 Vedic mathematics seminars, out of which 3 are seminars and 1 is a webinar. Yeah, by the exposure I had obtained from this institution, I went to conduct Vedic mathematics seminars in various organizations. I was invited and conducted Vedic mathematics seminar in Tambu Higher Secondary School in AJK College of Arts and Science. Recently, I delivered a webinar talk on career for mathematicians to the students of SMS College of Arts and Science. So I started my career as a postgraduate student in this institution, and I was invited as a resource person. And from the exposure I obtained from this institution, I was invited to almost all institutions around Coimbatore for conducting this Vedic mathematics seminar. So for achieving all these achievements, all these goals, the foundation was laid by our department, the Department of Mathematics of CMS College of Science and Commerce. So I feel very happy, delighted, and proud to say that I am also an alumni of this institution. So as a research scholar, I am going to tell these young students a few things which will definitely restructure your activities and mold you to achieve your goals. The first thing is, never underestimate yourself and never think negatively. Never underestimate yourself and never think negatively. Second thing is, think positively and begin your studies, work, whatever you do. Think positively and begin your studies, work, whatever you do. Third thing is, try to find the applications of all the topics that are being taught to you from the syllabus. Try to find applications of all the topics that are being taught to you from the syllabus. Fourth point is, now you are having some applications, no? Connect your syllabus problems with those applications so that you can understand the subject very effectively. Connect your syllabus problems with your applications so that you can understand the subject very effectively. Fifth point is very, very important. Blank your mind before preparing for exams and after completing exams. So if you are not blanking your mind before preparing for exam, means you will not get a clear idea about any concept. And if after completing the examination, if your mind was not clear, means that examination tension will remain in your mind forever. So always blank your mind before preparing for exams and after completing exams. Next thing is, try to understand the concepts, definitions, formulae, problems, etc. that are along the syllabus or out of syllabus. If it is not possible to understand, at least try to memorize, because understanding all the mathematical constant, all the mathematical concepts at a very first instant is not possible for everyone. If at all it is not possible, try to memorize it. Many people will say don't memorize mathematics, but it is not like that. Memorizing is the first step to understand, because from our childhood we don't know the meaning of numbers, we don't know the meaning of language we are speaking, we don't know the meaning of alphabets. So we begin our primary education by memorizing. We memorized numbers, then only we came to know the meaning of numbers. We begin to memorize the alphabets, the language. So being a child, we are observing the things, and the things are being pictured in our mind. That is called visual memory. So memory is a very good boon for mankind. So memorizing is a very big and very great brain exercise, which will help you to understand the things very earlier. So try to understand the concepts, definitions, formulae, problems, etc. if it is possible. Suppose if it is not possible, at least try to memorize those things, because memorizing is a great brain exercise which will help you to understand the things very earlier. Various opportunities are open for today's young students like you. You can become an entrepreneur, educationist, professional skill developer, IT employee, bank employee, etc. But with the requirement of learning and acquiring knowledge from recent trends in their field. Okay, so you can become whatever you desire, but you must be readily looking for the opportunities, and you have to learn and acquire the things which are being developed in the field. Okay, during my PG, I studied C++. Nowadays Java came into the syllabus. After a few days, now Python had entered into the syllabus. Okay, so whatever updates coming in the field, we must be ready to update ourselves. So that is very, very important to become a successful person in a career and as well as in our life. So some of you may go to job and some of you may go for higher studies. So research is a backbone for the development of our nation. So without research, any nation will not find a good development. So students like you should also come forward to study higher and higher and to pursue the research also. You have to go for PG, you have to go for MPhil, PhD, PDF. So education is limitless. Only we are having interest, then we can easily learn everything. So students should come forward to do research. Students should make use of funds, scholarships provided by both government and non-government sectors for doing the research. Many government agencies and non-government sectors are offering funds and scholarship for the students, so that the students can make use of all those funds and scholarships to pursue their research. So doing research is not at all a tough job. The only toughness is you have to think, you have to create a concept, and you have to work on it continuously. So that is very important. So last but not least, both learning and earning. Okay, both learning and earning are not possible without any hard work. Both learning and earning are not possible without any hard work. So my dear students, friends, be smart and work hard and come off with flying colors. Okay, thank you. I thank our Department of Mathematics, for providing me this opportunity to share some of the things I have experienced in my life. There are many things to say, but we have only some time constraints, because two more people are going to speak after me, who are my seniors. So I'm looking forward for their great speech also. I hope this session will definitely motivate you. So I thank Department of Mathematics for organizing this wonderful event. And I also thank the students who very patiently listened to my speech. I thank the institution, management, and I thank you all once again.
Thank you very much, Prashant. Any question to Prashant Bharati? Anybody would like to ask any question? Yes, actually, he's multi-talented person. Whether it is poem writing in Tamil, English, or drawing, or it is chess playing, or what is the other one called? Chilambam.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. And he has a YouTube channel also. You can just watch. You will see all his talents there. He will draw with two hands. So many things he does, actually. So it is very fascinating. If you observe him, it will be very, what to say? I have no words to explain. So fantastic.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah. And so, if I ask him to talk for even 2 hours, he will do, I know. But now I think in this platform, we are not encouraging it. We will have another session where we will invite him so he can talk on either on Vedic mathematics, he can talk on differential equations, he can talk, or even if you call for a general talk, he can do. If you call for a poem session, then that also he can manage. He has won so many awards for poem writing and poem recitation. He was felicitated by many. So many things are going on. Along with that, he has completed his PhD also. That is a wonderful thing. So all appreciations to you, Prashant Bharati, on behalf of the MS College. And we are very proud of you. Thank you very much for joining today.
Ma'am, thank you very much, ma'am. Because I was very, very blessed to have wonderful faculties like you and all the faculty members, ma'am. Because of your continuous motivation and encouragement only, it's possible for me to achieve all these great milestones in my life. Because if I was not motivated by professors or teachers who are behind our career, I cannot. It is not possible for anyone to achieve anything. So teachers are backbone for every student. And I was very blessed to have wonderful and good helping teachers like you. Srija ma'am, Kanibose sir, Vidya ma'am, Uma ma'am, David sir, Ramesh sir, Ganesh sir. So I thank all the faculties at this moment who handled classes for me. And I am very proud to say the alumni of this institution, CMS College of Science and Commerce. Thank you very much, ma'am.
I would like to add one more point, Srija, just 1 minute.
Okay.
So the first day when he joined PG, his parents, on either side, his parents were there holding the hand and bringing him to the department. We all were astonished to see that. But PG students, usually they come alone for the admission. Here the parents are bringing him. And every day his mother will call and ask me whether he has reached the college or not, whether he had his food or not. So he was so much pampered. But now he manages everything himself. That is a great thing. Yes, Srija, you can.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. Now, everything had possible because of the environment I had in that institution, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Very happy to see you, Prashant Bharati.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. I am also very happy to seeing you all and sharing some of the things with you all. I am very happy, ma'am. I am very happy to participate in this alumni fest, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Also very happy to hear that you are going to submit your thesis very soon. All the very best for your future also. Okay.
Thank you very much, ma'am.
You at this position. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. I'm also very happy, ma'am.
Now, shall we move on to Ambika Gayatri? So I extend a warm welcome to Ms. Ambika Gayatri. Ambika, please switch on your video also.
Hello, ma'am.
Yeah, Ambika, can you switch on your video also? At least
yes,
once.
Ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Hello, everyone. Hi. First of all, I would like to thank Mrs. Mrudula ma'am and Shalini for inviting me for this guest lecture, Alumni Fest. Like this corona, I'll keep it short actually. I'm Ambika Gayatri. I'm a 2006 passed out from CMS College, Mathematics Department. After that, I pursued my MCA. I was working as a lecturer for handling MCA students for quite a few years. And now I'm with State Bank of India as an associate. So I think this corona situation has put most of us in a standstill position, making us to think what next. But I guess you people might have chosen this mathematics for some reason, I guess. And I would like to say that you have made a very good wise decision by selecting this mathematics. That is because you know, maths is the core of everything. Wherever you go, maths applies. Even for engineering, mathematics is there. Basic, your day-to-day life, you can see that maths is there. In my personal experience, I was motivated by my faculty members to pursue higher education. I was given an option like what to choose, what not to choose, what are the opportunities that is lying in front of me. I was told each and everything by a very good guide of mine. And yes, I selected MCA and I went for attending exams, like what exams, competitive exams. And finally, I got placed in State Bank of India. And that is personally my opinion is because I chose mathematics as my basics. In my BSc, I selected mathematics. So that is the only point I could say, like I was able to clear my competitive exams without attending any coaching classes. Many of my colleagues will ask me, how did you clear without attending any coaching classes? But still I used to wonder how I completed or how I cleared my competitive exam. That is mainly because of selecting mathematics. So now this, right now, the corona situation, many of you will be wondering what to do next. Of course, many opportunities are lying in front of you. Now you are blessed with one more thing in your hand, that is your gadget, your mobile phones, which provides you vast information of opportunities that is lying in front of you. And you can go, like you are not restricted to only maths. So when you opt for maths, you can go for any other streams that is lying in front of you, be it computer science, or aeronauticals, whatever the stream that is lying in front, if you have a max basics, you have lots of opportunities lying in front of you. You can opt for anything. And if at all, if you want to go for a software, yes, I would like to say that even after completing your BSc mathematics, you are eligible to attend an interview for a corporate company, say for a software job. And all that they'll see is how far you're clear with your concept. Are you able to apply your concept in your day-to-day life? That is what they see. And since I have taught MCA, and many of my students are put up in Infosys, CTS, and Wipro, all they used to say is, after clearing the written test, they go for a personal interview, and that's it. They are just placed in a company. And the job that they do is, very easy to do it. That is because it's just a repetition of what every others do, and it is basically very easy to understand also. And one more thing is, like, you can enroll. You have got Telegrams, all those apps, you have got Telegrams where you'll get daily updates on the opportunities that is present right now, either be it a government examinations or be it any other recruitment drive that is happening anywhere in the part of India. You will get the updations right then and there. So I request each one of you to enroll to those kind of sites and make use of this time by preparing for competitive exams. Of course, you will find many competitive exams to come in near future. So since you are all max graduates, you will find it very easy. I don't think so. You have to go for any coaching centers for you to upgrade your knowledge. Since you're basically a max graduate, it will be very easy for you to understand the concept then and there. Only thing is time management. When coming to competitive exams, time management is the most important. How far you're, like for one question, how far you are spending the time, either the 30 seconds or 20 seconds. Make sure like you, it will be divided. Like for vocabulary, you'll have some, you yourself prepare it. For vocabulary, you'll allot only this part of your time. And for numericals, you'll divide only this part of your time. Like arithmetic, you'll divide only this part of your time. So divide accordingly and attend your competitive exams. I would suggest everybody to prepare for competitive exams that are coming now and then and there. Upgrade yourselves. See the newspapers where you can find advertisements for banks being published and any other government jobs that has been coming then and there. And you have got a very good source of gadget right on your hand, which is your mobile phone. Make a complete use of it. In our days, like I was a 2006 graduate, BSc Max graduates, we don't have a touchscreen mobile. Normal button mobiles were there that is only used for just calls and texting. That's it. But now we have got many things. You have got internet access. Make wise use of it. That's what I would advise each and every one of you. Make wise use of your net that you have got in your hand. It gives or it brings the world into your hand. To be simple, this one small gadget brings the world into your hand. You have got lots of information that is available, which is very easy to access. So make a wise use of your gadget that you're having. And the last, I would keep it very short. And the final thing is, just don't fret. Oh my God, what am I to do next? Of course, whatever you think, the universe brings back to you. That is what I would say. Have a positive thought. You have got lots of opportunities lying in front of you. Only thing is that you have to grab or you have to choose the right thing that is lying in front of you. I would say like you have selected BSc Maths, of course, each and every one of you would have selected this on some purpose. And you have made a very wise decision in selecting this Maths. And of course, there like this wise decision that you have done, you have got many opportunities that is lying in front of you. You have to grab that. That's it, ma'am. I would like to thank everyone for attending this session. I would thank Rudula ma'am and Shalini ma'am for inviting me for this speech. I would like to conclude my speech. Not.
Thank you very much, Ambika. And I would like to tell one point about her. So when they were learning, it was under university. It was not an autonomous college that time. And she's secured fourth rank in the university.
Thank you, ma'am.
So many years before, so
yes, ma'am, it was
not a problem. But in those days, it was really mattered. So she was the fourth rank holder of Bharatiya University in 2006, right?
Yes, ma'am, 2006. I hope my thoughts gave some light to the young minds there, ma'am.
Yes. So anybody would like to ask any question to her? She has experience as an MCA candidate as well as a engineering professor, then now she is a bank officer. In any area, you can put any question if you want. Anybody has got anything to ask?
Ambika, very happy to see you back after a long time.
Yeah, ma'am. Happy to hear from you, ma'am. Sure, ma'am. Our numerical methods, I think I got sent them in your paper, ma'am.
Yeah, sure. And, yes, about your family, where are you now?
Ma'am, I'm in Coimbatore only, ma'am. I'm working in State Bank. And
which branch?
I'm married. Coimbatore main branch, the one near railway station, ma'am.
Okay.
Your kids are sleeping or what?
No, ma'am. I have locked them outside. Otherwise, it would be a great disturbance right now. They would never leave me to speak, ma'am. They'll come and they'll peep and see what I'm doing and what I'm speaking, to whom I'm speaking. They'll ask questions to whom I'm speaking. So I've just put them out, ma'am.
Okay. What are they doing now? In schools or small kids?
They are 4 years old, ma'am.
Okay.
UKG.
Okay. Only one kid?
Twin boys, ma'am.
Twin boys, and, okay.
Yes. And one baby girl right now.
Okay. Very, very happy to hear from you.
Yes, ma'am. Okay. Happy to hear from you too, ma'am.
Okay. Thank you.
Take care, ma'am.
Okay.
So, thank you, Ambika. I think you can wait for another 10 minutes now. The third person also will finish his speech. Can you wait,
yes,
Ambika?
Or? Okay. So I'll wait, ma'am. I'll see, ma'am. I'll wait, ma'am.
Okay.
Thank you, ma'am.
This is kids, means you can leave, no problem.
Okay, ma'am. I'll check, ma'am. If urgency, I'll just cut the call, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah, thank you very much. If you are here, we'll meet again at the end of the session.
Sure, ma'am.
Janya, I think you have made a photograph.
Yes, ma'am. I have taken. Okay. Ambika, thank you so much.
It's okay, Shalini. Anytime.
Tips for our students. Really, it's great. Thank you. Very nice.
Really, thank you. Enakena students at least na space na edo oru point aada they can take it into their mind.
Yeah, if one of you respond back, it will be nice. No, many students are there.
It's okay, ma'am. Students are
okay, ma'am. Ninga oru bayangara motivation a irpinga the students kella.
Really, ma'am.
Banks padicha adutha adutha stage la how you can proceed forward on the
that
students
is, yes ma'am, BSc la enak or guidance irundhuchu ma'am, that is because of the faculty members, and we were really blessed. We had a classroom teaching. Ipo online la poi iruka, I don't know how far it is. On those days we were really blessed to have a classroom teaching where we could come to the department anytime for clarifying doubts or speaking with our staff members. அப்புறம் ஃபைனல் இயர் ப்ராஜெக்ட்ல வந்துட்டு ஐ பர்சனலி ஹேட் அ வெரி குட் கைடன்ஸ் ஃப்ரம் மிஸ்ஸஸ் கிரிஜா மேம் ஃபார் ஷுர். அண்ட் அகெயின் மை ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ்க்கும் நல்ல கைடன்ஸ் இருந்ததுதான். என்ன நெக்ஸ்ட் பண்ணலாம், பிஎஸ்சி மேக்ஸ் முடிச்சுட்டு என்னெல்லாம் ஆப்பர்ச்சுனிட்டிஸ் உனக்கு இருக்குங்கிறத கண்டிப்பா தே ஷீ டோல்ட் மீ வெரி வெல். இதுக்கு பிஎஸ்சிக்கு அப்புறம் யூ ஹவ் காட் சோ மெனி ஆப்பர்ச்சுனிட்டிஸ், தட் இஸ் வாட் ஐ வுட் லைக் டு டெல் தீஸ் ஸ்டூடெண்ட்ஸ் ஆல்சோ மேம். பிஎஸ்சி மேக்ஸ் முடிச்சுட்டு யூ ஹவ் காட் லாட்ஸ் ஆஃப் ஆப்பர்ச்சுனிட்டிஸ், இது மட்டுமே இருக்குங்கிறது மட்டும் தே ஷுடன் திங்க் மேம். Only also, thing is, they should gain more access to those knowledges. Nariya irukku ma'am.
Nanga usually class la we used to give our students as examples for our present students. Appo indha mari oru alumni eppadi irukanga nu therna appo we can give it as a motivation. Each and every sure, student ma'am. Of us they are very much important.
Yes ma'am. Okay. Thank you for reminding me, ma'am.
Okay, Rajiv, I think now you can take over.
Okay, ma'am.
Welcome. Please click on your video also.
Okay. Yeah. Good evening, everyone. Respected HOD, Dr. Midla, ma'am.
Are you at home or at institution?
Pardon, ma'am?
Are you at home or in
the institution? Yes, I am at home.
Oh, you have made a setup
for the
institution, I think.
Okay. Yes, for online purpose. Okay. I made this setup. Okay, ma'am. Good evening, all of you. Dr. Madhula ma'am, Srija ma'am, Uma Maheshi ma'am, Shalini ma'am, Vidya ma'am, and dear boss sir. And I'm very thankful to you for inviting me to this admin meet. And some of the lectures are also there on that time. Shyama ma'am, Ganesh sir, MS sir, Vivekananda sir, Manikandan sir, I never forgot them also. But now one is here. Okay. Then let me introduce myself to the students. My name is Rajiv B. And I am from Kerala. I am studying in Kerala, Payyanur, I don't know. Yeah, it's Charura, Painur Charura. And right now I am working with an institution in a college, Sri Narayana Guru College of Engineering Technology, as an assistant professor in mathematics. So ma'am told me to talk something about me for our students. So only because of CMS I reached here. Thoroughly I can say, because of the value of the certificate makes me like this, because for every interview that certificate is very valuable. So I got 82% in those days, 82% mark in that MSc mathematics. That mark is very important here in Kerala, because nowadays in Kerala that 60% 70% mark is very it's a top mark, but 82 is very good. So for every interview I will select first. I am going to select. I select. What I said in English not coming. Okay. Anyway, dear students, many opportunities are waiting for you. Because in Gulf countries, Oman, Kuwait, Bahrain, and so many Gulf countries, and Singapore and Malaysia, so many Indian schools are there. But just what one do is just complete your UG and PG from there. It's an easy task. So just do your work regularly and you will get the UG and PG degree from there. Just do your work regularly. That only I am saying here, there, from there. So many experience, I have many experience from the CMS. Because 2010 I joined there on the, just on July, yes. So on the July itself, I got an opportunity to go for an IB. That trip is to Delhi and Manali, along with Shyamam and Ganesh sir. It's a very enjoying moment. Is that I really enjoyed that. I'm very happy. And during that year, and also 2 year completed from there, and every ma'am in that institution motivated me. And ma'am, Uma once. Suddenly in the class, woman gave an assignment for us. So I done it well. So woman encouraged me that Raju's assignment is very good. That like an encouragement I got from there. I get privilege from that class. I am just motivated from that class. And also HOD ma'am is very sincere and very friendly, I know. But I said, after my PG, in 2012, I completed my PG from there. So next year itself, I got an appointment in a college. And next 2 years, that is 14 and 15, I worked in a government college, government schools as a plus two teacher. And again, the next year, I got an opportunity to work in a CBSE school. And next year, I went in Maharashtra. I got an opportunity in Maharashtra also. Maharashtra, so the state school, Alfonso school. And then next 2017-18 and 19 till 2020, I worked here only in Kerala as a PGT mathematics at a semi school. And right now I am working with this college. I am telling the students only I am reached here only because of that certificate, that is MSc certificate. So make it fast as it is possible. That is just do one thing. Just you completed all the works regularly and study regularly, you will get the MSc certificate. Above 80%, surely you get. And what I told. And these are the things about me, and these are the experience, and I came here like this. Thank you, ma'am.
Hello, Rajiv.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. How is your mom?
I'm good, ma'am.
Good. Very good. Okay. How many hours per day you are taking the class?
Now it is 2 hours, ma'am.
In online?
In online. Per week, 8 hours. For first, now it is for second semester, 4 hours. And fourth semester, 4 hours.
Okay. If it is in offline, means how many hours per week?
Offline is like the problem, ma'am. Because now this year only I joined there. Now offline class I got. Only online classes only I am getting here.
Oh. Have a bright future.
Okay, ma'am.
Rajiv also, when we joined, I think to everyone you used to talk in Malayalam only. Even to Tamil staff, you'll be talking in Malayalam.
Yeah, it's difficult to be speaking in English. So even though I talk in English.
Yeah, no, you have improved a lot.
Okay.
So
Rajiv? Yes, ma'am.
Rajiv, very happy to see you. All the very best.
Okay, Sajana.
Okay.